Hello, welcome. Thanks for reading or listening, I should say. Sorry. This is Ronda Del Boccio, and here's another magical story. I did this one for Friday Fictioneers, and that is a weekly blog challenge where you write a 100-word story. It's meant for fiction, but you know what? Sometimes some of us end up writing a memoir. So this is what I shared this week. There's a photo prompt each week. And this week it was a picture of a live performance, a stage theater, a bunch of people on it. Your story doesn't necessarily have to touch directly on it, but it will in some way. It just doesn't have to be like I'm going to the theater, so obvious. So it brought my childhood back to me. Now, I love theater. And before I tell you the name of the story, I love character parts. There is something that I heard from my mother through my whole life with her fat shaming and body shaming, which was that only fat people only get the character parts. Now, it's not that I expected to be the romantic lead. In fact, I love character parts. But it was just this, you're never good enough unless you're thin. And I was never built to be a thin person. Still not now and wasn't then. And actually, my nutritional profile, you wouldn't think I should be the size I am because I really do eat pretty well. So this is really not about whether I like character parts or not, because some of my commenters were onto that, but this is really about fat shaming. So the reason that the picture, it made me think of my childhood, that's mostly when I was in shows. I love being in theater. If I ever go to a show, I imagine what part would I like in that production on stage. So anyway, here is the story, which is called Fat People Only Get Character Parts. They think that tastes like chocolate? I don't care what it tastes like. Glaring at me, Mom slammed the canister of Cambridge diet powder she had bought me onto the table. She snapped an old pickle jar into my hand. I don't think I can do this. Fat people only get character parts. Never believe. I couldn't breathe. Just do it. Chin quivering with the effort to keep from crying, I went to my room and opened the floodgates. I took my lunch into the bathroom to consume it in a stall where, with tears streaming down my face. Thank you very much for reading or listening and whatever. If you found this on my blog or if you are listening to it, I really do appreciate you. And I hope you will come back and follow. There are stories I put up at least one or two a week, and I will say most of them are short. I might occasionally put a longer thing up, but by and large, everything is pretty quick, so you can consume it on the go. I am an author, and if you go to the blog, which will be linked there, you can get to my Amazon page. And They All Died Smiling is my recent paranormal book, and I have others as well. And I'm working on a book about my golden retriever, getting my guide dog from the school. So thank you very much. And I hope you will rate and review this podcast wherever it is you're listening. I'm now on Deezer, Podcast Addict, and a couple of others that I don't remember the name of because I've never heard of them, but woohoo, I'm there. So wherever you are, you can find this. And thank you kindly for reviewing and rating. Apparently, I am just not need to get my tongue checked. Well, thanks so much. And as always, cheers to your blissful life.